And we are ready to move to the next speaker of the day, who is Fabio Cecconi from the CNR Institute of Complex System in Rome. And Fabio will give us a talk entitled Competition Among Electrophoresis, Electroosmosis and the Electrophoresis in Particle Capture into Nanobots. So Fabio, when you want.
Okay, can you hear me?
Yes, we do.
Thank you, Carlo, and thank you to organizer for this nice workshop and giving me the possibility to work to discuss my work with you. This work is a collaboration with Mauro Chinappi, the University of Tor Vergata, Misai Jamai of the University of Tokyo of Agricultural Technology, and Kawano, Rui Kawano, the same university in Japan, from Japan. Okay. Sorry. Let me define what do we mean for molecule capture. Okay, capture is a stage, the early stage of molecule translocation. Suppose you have the molecules and here the nanopore. In the technological applications of nanopore sensing, it is important that the capture, the molecules can be captured in a quite efficient way to be analyzed. And so what we mean for capture is the fact that the molecules arrived at the nanopore without rebounding back into the solvent, into the bulk, and interact with the nanopore till to make the translocation. Of course, for nanopore sensing, poor capture means poor analysis. So it's important to understand the mechanism which leads this capture, and just to improve basically the operational efficiency of nanopore devices. What are the effect that we can at work in this phenomenon is electrophoresis, dielectrophoresis, solvent drugs due to electroosmosis and also to pressure gradient, and also diffusion, thermal agitation of the solvent and of the molecules, and finally chemical interaction with the nanopore. Okay. Just to make things clear, what we mean for electrophoresis is basically is well known, is the motion of charged molecule to the electric field, and depending on the charge. What is the electrophoresis is a more complex effect, because it occurs when particles have dipole, which can be induced or permanent. So the particle first align along the flow, the field lines. But if the field is not homogeneous, like, for example, happens in the proximity of the nanopore, then the molecule can experience also a translational force that is proportional to the gradient of the field, so to the dishomogeneity of the field. Finally, there is also electroosmosis at play in the capture mechanism. Electroosmosis is the motion of an electroneutral solvent. Basically, if the pore is charged, the electroneutrality in this region is violated. So an applied field can induce the motion of ions, so the unbalancing, because there is the unbalancing of the charges, there is the motion of charges, and this motion can induce the motion of the solvent, basically water, that is able to drag also molecule toward the pores. And this is the expression of the velocity induced by the electroosmotic effect. How can we model in a simple way, mathematically, all this effect in one equation, let's say? Okay, we need to make the approximation, hemispherical electrode approximation. It means that far from the electrodes, we can assume that there is a radial symmetry. So the field lines are basically radial. And with this approximation, we obtain the expression of the field from simple electrostatic consideration. This EI is the current which is obtained by applying the voltage. And with this expression, we can compute all the terms that I have discussed. And this is the electro-osmotic flow. This depends on the field, so on the voltage, and this is the electrosmotic flow. This contribution can be obtained by a potential that can be written in a simple way. Basically, this potential depends on the distance from the pore, one over r, and the electrophoresis terms depends on the square of the distance, in the inverse of the square of the distance from the nanopore. Okay. Now the continuum model the continuum model can be obtained by considering as a sorry, but the mouse is can be obtained by by introducing the concentration of the molecule to be captured. We use a Smoluchowski equation, which means that the dynamics of the molecules is driven by fields, but also there is a thermal agitation, so it's a noisy dynamics. We write the conservation of species, and so the mass conservation, basically. And finally, we can write the flux of the molecules approaching the pore. And here we have the three different contributions: diffusion, advection, which means electrosmosis in this case, and also phoresis, dielectrophoresis and electrophoresis. This similar approach has been used also from other people in the literature. Okay, the simplified assumption to arrive at analytical solution of the model is are basically three: the radial symmetry, so the fact that C of R, the concentration of molecule to be captured, depends only on the radius, on the distance from the pore. So all the vectors fields can be written proportionally to R, to the direction of the from the pore. And then we also introduce the solvent incompressibility. Basically, we are considering like a solvent the water. So this incompressibility is written by using this divergence equal to zero. And this constraint gives a simple expression of the electrosmotic field that depends on the inverse of the square of the distance. Finally, we have to introduce boundary conditions at the entrance of the pore and at the bulk. Far from the pore, we assume that the particle concentration depends, is given by the bulk concentration, basically, while near the pore, we assume radiation boundary condition or Robin boundary condition, which means the absorption is not perfect. In fact, if K is zero, there is a total reflection. When K is infinite, the absorption is ideal because C in the proximity of the pore is zero. Okay. Now we are ready to solve our equation. That is so simple because it's one-dimensional problem in the coordinate R. We computed the stationary solution that is given by putting this to zero. And then Okay, we can solve this and you obtain finally the molecule distribution as a function of the distance from the pore. When k is infinite, this part goes going to zero, and we have we remain with this part that is the idle capture, while for k equal to zero, this dominates, and we remain with the total reflection. So particles are not captured. Since we have a simple potential form, we can make the analytical. We can make the analytical computation, and so we obtained the profile of the concentration. You see that when k, the parameter k, increases, the molecules accumulate the pore entrance. So because there is no capture, no efficient capture. Okay. Finally, we are interested basically in the capture rate. The capture rate is easy obtained in this model by computing the flux of the current. If you do that, you can obtain the expression of the capture rate. And see, if you invert this expression, you see that there are two mechanisms at working. The first is due to the entrance problem, the entrance mechanism, because depends on k. While the second mechanism is due to the transport phenomena, and we call that the approaching rate. Okay. So next, this model basically split the capture rate in two parts: the entrance and the approach. Okay. Let me see how it works. For example, for when there is the competition between phoresis and electrosmosis. Consider, for example, electrophoresis and electrosmosis. So you are considering basically charged molecules and charged pore. In this case, you see that our model predicts for the approaching frequencies against the voltage this expression, this curve, and this is pure electrophoresis. But if to the electrophoresis superimposes the electrosmosis, you see that there is an answer of the capture or a decrease of the captures. So electrophoresis can play both roles, depressing or enhancing. Also, the interesting thing is that if there is electrophoresis, you can have also capture, so frequency very high, at negative voltage. So there could be capture also against the voltage, against the field. So electrophoresis basically is a power mechanism for enhancing capture. Okay. And finally, in this case, we can consider dielectrophoresis, so molecules with dipole, and electrosmosis. Even in this case, you have that electrophoresis this is pure dielectrophoresis, and electrosmosis can enhance or depress the capture depending on the values of the charge of the pore. What is interesting in this curve, that you see that there is a symmetric view shape in the capture process. So electrophoresis basically gives a symmetric mechanism for capturing. So V and minus V is the same. Okay. Now we have to, as I told you, there is a mechanism of entrance because we schematize. So we model with k, with k is a parameter, but this parameter should depend from some important properties of the pore, and we don't know how to model this interaction, but we can say that k should depend on the free energy that the molecule see at the entrance of the pore. And simple hypothesis means that you can consider Ehring-Polanyi expression, so basically an Arrhenius formula. And so we model analytical computation, we model this k with this exponential formula. Now, with this exponential formula, we can compute the capture frequencies depending on the entrance, and we have this expression. And if we plot the capture frequency against voltage, considering this expression of the k, we can obtain different curves, and you see that there are two regimes. This is the entrance limited regime, and this is the transport limited regime. So here is important the barrier that the molecule feels at the pore. Here instead, if the voltage is very high, the barrier is neglected, and only what matters is the field which drives the molecule toward the pores. Also, the same scenario can be obtained with the electrophoresis, and here there is also a transport limited regime and an entrance limited regimes. So, and you see that again, you have the V shape, the chevron plot, basically it's called in chemistry, the chevron plot, and reflecting the symmetry due to the symmetry of the dipole, basically. Okay. We compared also our prediction with some experiment just to play. If we were just curious to see what happens if you make a serious comparison with experiments. And so we consider the experiment by Larkin and co-workers of 2014. They consider two proteins, RNAs and protein K, driven toward the solid state pore that is a few oxide. This is a solid state nanopore that is quite large. And so there is no barrier at the entrance, so the capture is only limited by the transport. Here you see the capture frequency predicted by our model, and this is the voltage, and you see, okay, that this is an increase of course of the capture with the voltage, and it means that electrosmosis and electrophoresis cooperates because the pore is positively charged, and when V is positive, there is a cooperation of electrophoresis. What we can say about our comparison with the experiment that we predicted capture frequencies that basically is four times smaller than experimental one. And this is not surprising, but because our theory has no adjustable parameters, we took exactly the parameters of the experiments and we put in our formulas, and discrepancy in this case, I think that can be considered quite acceptable. Finally, since there were no literature experiments on DP, the electrophoresis capture, we asked to our colleagues, experimental colleagues, to conceive an experimental in this context, and they use the experimental setup that is sketched in this picture. You see that there is a double well chip here, The double web. Mamma mia. Ok. Fa così. The double web chip. And you put the layer droplet containing the bilayer. If you put in contact them, you obtain the structure in this. They make a contact. They make here a leap in the contact region. They make a leap bilayer, and you can manage this droplet. These two droplets joined together, and you can measure. Manage this this droplet, introducing your biological pore and the solution, of course, and also the molecule to be captured. Just to obtain a molecule with a permanent dipole, the experimentalists designed a rigid hairpin peptide with the extremity, the terminals to arginine, with that are positive charged, and two aspartic acid and the turn that are negative. So to obtain a rigid dipole, they measure the capture frequency, consider as measured as the time the pore is open between two translocations. So, and finally, we obtain this kind of plot that we are able to fit quite reasonable by assuming our theory and considering, in this case, unfortunately, the energy barrier as a parameter to be adjusted. And this is quite reasonable because we don't have any information about the barrier at the entrance of the pore. So, okay, I am at conclusion. So we propose an analytical model of molecule capture into nanopores. We use a different approximation to arrive at an analytical expression. First, the continuum medium approximation, the radial symmetry, the radiation boundary conditions. That means there is the effect that mimics the effect of the entrance variance at the pore entrance, and the incompressibility of the solvent. And finally, we write a driven diffusion process, or Smoluchowski equation, basically. And we were able to study the interplay between electrophoresis, electrosmosis, dielectrophoresis, and barrier effect at the pore entrance. The results basically says that the capture time split into two contributions, the approaching time driven by the transport, and the entrance time depending on the barrier that the molecules encounters near the pore. We compare theoretical prediction with some experiment in the literature, finding basically an agreement with the order of magnitudes of the capture frequency. We propose a criterion for discriminating transport-driven and entrance-driven capture. And finally, we make a dedicated experiment of dielectrophoresis with a rigid peptide with permanent dipole, and to test our prediction, our theoretical prediction against experimental data. The agreement with experimental result is acceptable because you see that we are able to explain the V shape of the Chevron plot of the capture rate, and possible application of our theory is on nanopore basic technology. So if you just to try to improve the capture mechanism around nanopores. Thank you for your attention, and okay, I
thank you. Thank you, Fabio. So we are a bit late, but maybe there is time for one or two quick questions. So Matteo Ceccarelli says, in biological selective pore, it was demonstrated that for dipolar neutral molecule, the association rate is not symmetric in voltage because there is a preference of entry into the charged pore.
Ah, yes, maybe there is, of course, probably is so, but in our theory, this effect is not included. And what can I say is that if you look at this experimental data, maybe there is some kind of asymmetry, but is in this case, in this kind of experiment, is quite small. Is quite small. Maybe you are right.
Okay, so if there are no other questions by the audience, I have a curiosity. So could you comment on the possible technological applications of the electrophoresis and electroosmosis, for instance, in the field of polymer sequencing or other fields?
Yes, basically there are two mechanisms that can be used to capture the polymers. Against, for example, some when you are not able to capture them with the electrophoresis, for example, if you for example are able to engineering some polymer making a dipole, for example, adding two different charged particles at the terminals. This induces a dipole that orients along the field lines, so the polymer becomes some spring, rigid spring, because there is also a competition, tug of war of the due to the field, the opposite charges. So the polymer becomes quite stiff, and the electrophoresis is able to, if you are able also to generate a gradient of electric field, you are able to import polymers into non-charged polymer into a nanopore. Also, electrosmosis is the same. Electrosmosis is able to import, for example, there is a work by Knappi and co-workers, which show that electrosmosis is able to import peptides against the electric field. So suppose that you have an electric field pointing outside the pore, outward the pore, there is the possibility with electrosmosis to make a mechanism that is able to import the molecule. That's so simple. Basically, in nanopore sensing devices, the capture is the first stage. So it's important to understand what happens and what are the possibility.
Thank you very much. So there are messages by Sergei Sugarev and Mark Sampson, but I think you will have to answer privately, because we are terribly late. So okay. We thank you again, Fabio, and all of the speakers of the session, and we meet again at 10 past 11 at the end of the coffee break. There will be the talk by Armagan Kosa, so don't miss it out. Okay, so see you later and stay tuned.